begin with, we have musical performance by our Arijit Singhs and Neha Kakkars, who will sing us some mellow Bollywood hits.
Yeah. Thank you.
Dennis, Mr. Literature.
Please Wordsworth, be it good God. Remy Dennis knows them all.
Pranan Sharma and Pushpa Kaur.
Mr. Ethical,
his soul is an amalgamation of every Greek philosopher.
Miss Blue Chip,
prim and proper to the T, she's always bubbly.
Pulkit Chandelier
and Sneha Irenwa, Mr. Bookaholic.
Drunk on the smell of the library, this man is not hammered, he is grammared.
Miss Enchanting, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? Never was a tough call, it's Sneha after all. Rahul Raj and Sanya Kataria, Mr. Lionhearted.
Brave and stubborn to a fault, this man never backs down from challenges.
Miss Aesthetic, she likes her money where she can see it, hanging in her closet. Richard Gupta and Saksham Mishra.
Mr. Innocent.
Kind and intelligent, he's the last person on the suspect list. Mr. Dapper.
On the top of the trends, this man can fit in all stands out of any time and anywhere.
Hey, we have a dance shoot here right now. Let's go.
Thank you. Oh! Bandaru Bandu Bandaru 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 Bandaru
every week because of her.
Mr. Cannon, not once to mince his words, you can always go to him to get a reality check.
Jawahar Singh Rathore
and Shreyansi Srivastava. Miss Sparkly Eyes, the cutest girl in DIS. She'll never fail to mesmerize everyone with her personality.
Mr. Dauntless, nothing can faze this man. It seems like his skin is made of iron. Ishanvi Chauhan.
And Abhijit Singh Rana, Miss Amiable, willing to get along with everyone, she despises violence. Mr. Generous, he surely must have a heart problem due to how open his heart is. Siddhant Sachdeva and Akshat Bihani. Mr. Spontaneous.
Always prepared for anything. You can never catch him flat-footed.
Mr. Companionable. Soul of every group. He'll never allow you to brood. Mesmerizing style, always ready to put a smile.
Arwan Chen and Lavanya Jindal.
Mr. Virtuous, his morals are so high that Mount Everest feels shy. Miss Congenality, knows it all, balance sheet or a bank call.
Meghani Abhi, Mr. Impeccable, prim and proper without any flaws. This man never breaks any laws.
Miss Ashita Sharma, Miss Iconic, her heart echoes the melody of monsoon. Garv Pratap and Katyayani Chhabra, Mr. Brisk, pride in walk, pride in talk, run away enemies, cause he's got a Glock.
Katyayani Chhabra, Miss Munificent, words can't describe how amazing she is, but numbers can. She is 11 out of 10. Lavanya Rawat, Mr. Prince Charming. Tale of a musician, gale of energy, fondness in heart, bold and smart.
Kanishka Nefram, Mr. Dandy, a total confusion, British or American.
How can you forget that? It's Bollywood.
How can we have the theme of a film of Bollywood and not have a movie in it? It shouldn't be like that.
You are right. So ladies and gentlemen, before we move forward, we would like you all to sit back and have a wonderful time enjoying some of the beautiful memories created by the outgoing batch of 2023.
Oh, बाकी हैं मेरे दोस्त हैं।
Like to everyone, this man has no enemies. Shivam Rathi. Mr. Rathurus, life of the party, it's Shivam Rathi.
Old chairs bar, Mr. Diligent. Ding dong the bell, who is going to tell? Never dreamt to fail, that is the head boy on the rail. Priyanka Biswas, Miss Pretty Smile. Just like the little stars, she twinkles bright. Thanks to her smile, she faces every challenge with pride.
Tanishi Barnawal, Miss Affinity. Be it Scorpio, be it Gemini, Tanishi's affinity with them is a scar.
Roshan Gupta, Mr. Knightley, valiant and courageous, he condemns deeds which are outrageous.
Yes, Singer, Mr. Benevolent, kind-hearted and understanding, this man is outstanding. Stalks the sock and hides under the clock.
Roshan Shah, Mr. Studious.
Where Google is fail, where books come pay, Roshan Shah never fails. To be serious when times are the worst.
Abhijit Gupta, Mr. Dynamic, ready to accept any obstacle with zeal, he is known for his hard-working nature. After all, he is Mr. Dynamic.
Vanya Mehta, Miss Spanish. Not caring what, because about what others thinking about her. Her real beauty is in the way. She is comfortable in her own skin. Her attitude is not a mirage, but she just is Mr. Panache.
Arihan Bharadwaj, Mr. Paparazzo. With his photography experience and camera in his hand, he reminds us of the Italian paparazzo.
Mr. Stupendous, his action has certainly sent something to be wondered at.
Hansika Singh, Miss Rosy Cheeks. Her beauty is like the untouched dew on roses at dawn. Great to look at, but also useful and a pretty sight.
Raj Grover, Mr. Distributed Invisible, be it Draw, be it NPA at Sherlock Holmes. Yuvraj's location is always unknown.
Yugandhar Chaudhary, Mr. Lifeaholic, living life to the fullest, he'll cheer you up no matter what.
Thank you.
ये बाप राव
तहेबान कदरदान मेहरबान दिल थाम के बैठिए क्योंकि अब आपके सामने तशरीफ ला रही है मोदी।
समाचार कुछ इस प्रकार है।
दिल भर है
That was fun and surely made us groove on the beats.
That's true. But moving forward, have you noticed everyone is looking fabulous today?
For sure. But some of them are adding a different kind of spark to this evening.
You are absolutely right. That's exactly what I was thinking about. Amidst all our celebrities who walked on the red carpet today, some of them are looking different and adding a different kind of spark to this evening.
Please pick up a chit.
You all are requested to pick up a chit from the board, which carries the question that you'll be answering. I'd like to start with Vedika Singh. If you were a ghost, whom would you haunt from the school? Actually, I will haunt the whole school. Yes. And in particular, I will haunt Divas ma'am because, yes, I want to see how she dresses up, how she makes her hair, how she makes up, and everything. Thank you.
If you are given a chance to live on Moon or Mars, would like to leave this planet and why? I would not, I'll stay in this planet only as I like this planet more than Moon and Mars. I have so much of friends here, so many friends like them. I'll miss them also. Yeah, just them. Thanks.
If you had a choice, which era would you like to born in? I would like to born in the same era because there are many reasons. First of all, the school and the people who exist in the school. Thank you.
Kunal Jaisi.
If you are the brand ambassador of the school, how would you promote the school? First of all, thank you teachers for making me the brand ambassador. And I would like to show this show as a life for promoting the school, how beautiful people are over here. And many more things. Thank you.
Mohit Raj.
There is given, who is the one person you envy the most in your bat and ball? I'll go with the Kanishka because you know what, he's the one who get the return, like, he get the return within a short term. And we are running for 12 months and getting a return.
What is one thing you want to see changed in the school 10 years from now? That's a tough one. Okay, so although I've been in the school since I was in 11th, but I've seen the school evolve a lot in these 2 years, and I'm sure after 10 years it would have reached great heights. So I don't think there's anything to change about the school. It's already amazing. Thank you.
Sian
most about yourself. So I never spoke in public ever since I came in my senior years. I think I like my personality the most, and I even embrace the anxiety that I have speaking here right now. Thank you. Kapdan Chawla. Good evening. So my question is, if one day you wake up as the principal of the school, what would be the first thing you do? So I would wake up and resign and reach out to directors and tell them to appoint Sir, because I think he's perfect at his job and he's Hi, good evening everyone. My question is, what makes you unique? Well, I feel like everybody is unique in their own ways. What makes me unique is my thoughts and how I'm comfortable with my own skin and confident. So I would really suggest all of you to be comfortable and confident in your skin as well and stand unique. Thank you. We have a special mention. We'd like to call Ada Kapoor and Chris Remy Dennis on the stage.
The question is, what do you like the most about yourself? I'll have to think about it. Take a second. Okay, come on, height is genetics, not even genetics. It's probably how I don't care about anything. Because it does not matter to me what anyone thinks about me, what people are saying. I just carry on because I'll be very honest, I hate people. So I just do what I want.
Please give these contenders a huge round of applause for their wonderful answers. Respected judges, you are free to ask questions from any of the contenders if you wish to. You may choose a question from the sheet given in your folder or ask any question you would like. Thank you so much. Your results will be.
In this era of gender equality, can I ask for anyone or?
Anyone, sir.
Okay, anyone can answer. Ashita, you answer. In this era of gender equality, would you still expect a gentleman to get up and give you a seat? Did I repeat?
Sir, can you please repeat the question?
In this era of gender equality, would you still expect a gentleman to get up and give you a seat?
Sir, I don't think so. I would take the seat myself, but if he wishes to, that's all right. That's not my problem. But I think in today's era, feminism is more important than gender equality. Thank you. Questions?
Good evening, everyone. You all are looking fabulous. Okay, this question is for Katyani.
To which famous personality do you find yourself pally with?
Can you just repeat your question?
Yeah. To which famous personality do you find yourself pally with?
I would say that she's not really a famous personality, but for me, she's the famous. That would be my mother. I mean, it's her that I always look up to, and I want to be just like her. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, contenders. Your results will be announced soon. Towns and the highways. But sometimes a moment stuns us as it happens, and we know that this instance is more than a fleeting image. And the same way as we walk out the 12th East from here, the walls will bear the stories of the most precious years of our lives. I am so grateful for our respected directors, Principal Sir, Vice Principal Ma'am, teachers and members of faculty who have influenced us to do the best we can and explore the sides of us which we never knew existed. There were times we laughed our guts out, we cried, we screamed out with joy, with school trips, common room sessions with the best mentors ever, late night talkings, shared this stage and many others, participated as a team, cherished the victory, learned from the failures, and lived to the fullest. All these moments we've shared are just priceless. When I walk through the greens of the school, there's a feeling that I'm cared for. There's a presence of warmth, and now that it's time we leave school, I wonder if that security will ever leave us again. When I speak on the behalf of my classmates who've been a part of this incredible institution for years, for those who've literally spent their childhood here, entered their teens, and today they're ready to face the real world, they've grown with the school each year. Moving on to the best hosts we could ever ask for, our beloved juniors, the 11th East. The love you've given to us and all your efforts for putting this immortal evening together piece by piece with the help of your great teachers. We believe this is hands down one of the best farewells in the history of Doon International School Riverside campus, and will definitely be a benchmark for yours. So can we have a huge round of applause for them? We love you so much and always will. And the time is soon that you all take over the senior most class and play a major role in the council body. With the trust we put in you, without a doubt, we can say all of you will uphold the responsibilities in the best way possible and shine brighter by filling in all the parts where we unknowingly lacked. And if there's one thing to take away from what I say is that live your each day at DIS with your heart. Do not back out from expressing yourself, because one day it will all come to an end, so why not end it with a feeling of pride and unity? This day is filled with many emotions. We feel elated, yet dejected, happy, yet sad, and this is one of the last nights we spend with our friends and teachers. The feeling will seep in later as the day concludes, but you will wish it had never ended. Now, to conclude, as I started my journey as the school captain with a little part of my poem, I would love to end it the same way with its conclusion. What do you fear the most, they asked me. What do you fear the most, they asked me. With a faint smile across my face, looking straight in their eyes, a few glimpses right in front of me, question marks gazing all over me. No, it is not losing my lover, it is not reaching those endeavors. These are not my fears. It's our moments, it's the smile of my people, it is the warmth of nature, it is the only hope. And maybe it is living life each day I breathe. Thank you, DIS, for giving me all of it. This was Katyayani Chhabra signing out as the head girl for session 2022-23.
Thank you. Now I'd like to call up on the podium our Honorable Director, Mrs. H.S. Mann, to address the cabinet.
Our revered principal, Mr. George, Vice Principal, Ms. Sanju Verma, our Head of Administration, Colonel Singh, my fellow director, Ms. Sonika Mann, members of the staff, and my beloved children from class 12 and class 11. As I was sitting there hearing these two wonderful young adults on the verge of stepping out of the portals of the school and speaking about their experiences, the thought came to me that with this life that lies ahead of you, there is very little that I can say that will prepare you for it. Life will be difficult. Life will throw challenges at you. Life will test you. Life will ask questions out of you. And very often life will try and defeat you. So what is it that will help us wade through these challenges, be the best version of ourselves, live a happy and fulfilling life, and make sure that we make the most of every moment that we are blessed to have on this planet? Now that is something that at the school we have tried to prepare you for. The qualities that we have tried to imbibe in you are preparations for life, to be hardworking, to be disciplined, to have the right values, to have empathy for your fellow human beings, to be a responsible member of any community. Whilst you were at school, you were a member of the student community, where you were expected to be responsible for all your actions. When you step out, you will go to different colleges and institutions, but you will also be a part of a larger community, and that is the society at large. How will you contribute to it? How will you distinguish yourself? How will you set yourself apart from the crowd? And how is it that you will choose to leave a mark on anybody who you touch? Many exist, but how many actually live? That is the question that we need to ask. And how are we going to achieve what we want to achieve with what we have been prepared for whilst our school life has been on? Children, I wish all of you the very best for what lies ahead. Please understand that school is a very protected existence. It is something that will never happen again in your life. Right from the time to what you're wearing, to how your hairstyle is, to whether you've eaten, to whether you have finished your work, to whether you're going on time, what is your attendance, to whether you have eaten your meals on time. It is all going to be up to you now. The things that we in school often hate are things that we miss for the rest of our lives. The atmosphere of being around people who are constantly looking out for us, constantly ensuring that we are presenting the best version of ourselves. And today when you step out, it is with the hope that you are now mature enough, responsible enough to now take all those responsibilities on your own shoulders rather than all of us watching out for you or your parents. You're 18, you're going to be allowed to vote in next year's general elections. That will be your first step into adulthood, and that is how responsible you would be considered when you can choose your own government, is when you will also be held accountable for each one of your actions. You've been a wonderful batch. I do get regular feedback about all of you, and I'm delighted that all of you have lived up to the spirit that Riverside wants to imbibe in all our students. And you will tomorrow go out and be wonderful examples of what alumni of this school ought to be. Today all of you looked dapper, handsome, beautiful, and suddenly adults. And that is that one big change that's going to take place after you finish your board examinations in March. The world of adulthood awaits you, and on behalf of all of us, our teachers, the management, and everybody else at the school who's had the privilege of knowing all of you, of having been in touch with all of you through the most formative years of your life, having been seeing you through your ups and downs, through your teens, through the most unforgettable years of your life, and if I had the privilege of having seen you wear this wonderful blue uniform of the school, we wish you the very best of luck. Go out, make us proud, make your parents proud of what you are, and be the best version of yourself, and be a wonderful citizen of this country, and indeed this world. So may God bless you with great success, great happiness, and a wonderful life ahead. And we will certainly miss you at the school. As and when you get the opportunity and you're around on the Founders Day or otherwise, please do make it a point to come back and meet all your teachers and everybody else who's been in touch with you at the school. So once again, wish you the very best of luck, dear children, and may God bless you with the most wonderful, happy and fulfilling lives. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So this is the moment that everyone has been waiting for. The results are out. I would like to call upon the stage our directors, Principal Sir, Vice Principal Ma'am, and Head of Administration to award the title winners. First up on the list, we have Mr. and Ms. CBSE Awards based on their academic performance. So Mr. CBSE goes to, any guesses?
Danny.
It's true, it's Danny Dilip George. Please give him a huge round of applause. Next up, we have Miss CBSE. It isn't easy to guess, so the award goes to Pushpa Kugar. Please welcome her on the stage with a huge round of applause. Next up are the Mr. and Ms. CBS Riverside Awards based on the performance and contribution throughout the year. So Mr. Riverside goes to Rahul Raj. Thank you. Miss CBSE, any yesses?
Miss Katya Eni.
Miss Katya Eni. It's true. It's Katya Eni Chawla. Now comes the very much awaited award, the Star of the Evening Award, based on the turnout of students this evening. Star of the Evening Boy, any guesses? I'm so sorry, it goes to Chris Remy Dennis. Let's give him a huge round of applause.
The next one as well, yeah, the other one.
Star of the Evening Girl goes to Vanya Mehta. Can we have all the awardees on the stage to get a picture clip? Thank you and congratulations to everyone. I request our directors, principal sir, vice principal ma'am, and head of administrations to stay on the stage for a cake cutting ceremony to wish luck to the outgoing batch of 2022 and 23. Thank you.
chefs with such a beautiful cake. The chefs also.
Ma'am.
One picture over there.
For all land sign,
for all landsign, my dear, for all landsign, we'll tak a cup, oh kindness yet, for all landsign, for all landsign, my dear, for all we'll tak a cup, oh kindness yet, for